In this video, I teach you a water cooling system in the details and the various topic like as the basic of water cooling system, advantages of water cooling system, disadvantages of water cooling system, what is natural circulation cooling system, what is forced circulation cooling system, open cooling system and closed cooling system. So first we understand the water cooling system. So its name is suggest that the cooling of the engine is takes place by using the water. That's why it is known as the water cooling system. In air cooling system, the cooling of the engine is takes place by the air. So in last video we understand the air cooling system, its advantages and disadvantages also. So this is the engine and this is the cylinder body. Then after this is the inside part is known as the cylinder liner. This is the water space, or it is also known as the water jacket. So it is provided in a cylinder body. Okay, so this, when the cylinder is heated due to combustion, so this heat energy is absorbed by the cylinder liners. So we need to cool the cylinder liner, and the cylinder liner is cooled by using the water space. Okay, or it is known as the water jacket. In this matter of the cooling, the cylinder walls and the head are provided with jacket. Okay, not only the cylinder walls, but cylinder head is also provided. Cylinder head means this upper part is also provided with a jacket through which cooling liquid can circulate. The cooling liquid is circulated by the naturally or by the force that we understand later on. First, we understand the basic. The heat is transferred from cylinder wall to the liquid by convection and conduction. Means first here the combustion is takes place. Then this liner is heated, so from inner layer of the liner to outer layer it is transferred by conduction, and then after this outer layer of the cylinder body or a cylinder liner is transferred the heat to the water by using the convection heat transfer. The liquid become heated in its passage through the jacket, means the liquid become heated in its passage through the jacket and itself cooled by means of the air cool radiator system. Means this water is not enclosed. Okay, this water is further supplied to the another heat exchangers, or it is a continuously circulated, means it is the open system that we understand later on. Okay, how this water is circulated, that is depend on the open system or a closed system. The heat from the liquid in turn is transferred to the air, means this heat energy of the water, means water is again cooled by using the air. Okay, in a radiator or in a condensers, or it is also cooled by a water, that is depending upon the system that we understand later on. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe the channels by pressing the subscribe buttons, and also visit the playlist for watching the various video related to the mechanical engineering. So first we understand the advantages of water cooling system. It's provide the uniform cooling of the cylinder head and valve. Okay, in an air cooling system, what is the disadvantage? That is a non-uniform cooling is produced because the circulation of air is different in a different parts of the engines. Specific fuel consumption of an engine improve by using the water cooling system. In this system, engine did not be provided at the front end of the moving vehicles. In air cooling system, what we study? In air cooling, engine is provided at the front part of the vehicles. But when the engine is water cool, it is not necessary to provide on the front part. We are also able to install the engines on the rear part of the vehicles. Okay. So this is the advantage of the water cooling system. Engine is less noisy as compared with the air cooled engine, as it has a water for damping the noise. It's a less noise because of the water is absorb the some quantity of the noise. Now disadvantages of water cooling system. It depends upon the supply of water. If water is not available in a water jacket, then the cooling is not proper. Engine temperature is increased. So it is depend upon the supply of water. The water pump which circulate the water absorb considerable power. So in a water cooling system, one pump is used. So it's absorb the some quantity of the power. If the water cooling system fails, then it will result in damage of the engine. Means that is a various part like the pump is stopped. Okay, then the water cooling is stopped, water circulation is stopped. So it damages the engine. The water cooling system is costlier as it more number of parts. In a water cooling system, the part is more compared to the air cooling system. So also it's required more maintenance and the care for its part. The water cooling systems can be classified as natural circulation water cooling system, forced circulation water cooling system, open cooling system and the closed cooling system. So we understand this all the systems in the detail. So first we understand the natural circulation of the cooling. So its name is suggest that the natural circulation of the cooling. Okay. Suppose in our room, how the circulation of the air is takes place. Okay. So we use the fan, then it is known as the forced circulation. If the fan is not there, means we off the fan, then how the circulation of the air takes place inside the room. Okay. So it is called as the natural circulation. I mean, when the fan is off, at that time it's called as the natural circulation, and when we on the fan, the forced circulation of the air is start. So we understand the natural circulation. The circulation of water is by thermosiphon principles, means there is no any extra devices used like the blower or a pump or that. Okay, because it is a water cooling system. For water cooling system, generally transporting the water, we need to use the pump. Okay, so in natural circulation system, the pump is not use. The circulation of the water is by using the thermosiphon principle. Now what is the thermosiphon principle? Where water is heated, okay, its density is increased and the low density of the water is start to moving in upper direction, so it's called as the rise up. So hot water is rise up inside the water jacket and the cool water is start to moving into the downward direction due to the density difference. So here you see it is the diesel engine. Inside this diesel engine, the water jacket is provided. So we supply the cold water from the lower sides, okay, and it start to absorb the heat in a water jacket. So its temperature is increased, means its density is decreased. Okay, that's why due to low density, the water is start to moving in the upper directions and the hot water is out to the engine. So it is depend on the open or closed system, this hot water is supplied to the which location, that we understand into the open system and closed system. The cold water moves downward to take its the place, and in this manner the circulation of water takes place. Means cold water is supply from the bottom sides, it's absorb the heat, then it start to moving in upper directions. Okay, and suppose that is a cold water is available in upper part, then it start to move downward direction and hot water is start to move in the upper direction due to the density difference. So this is known as the thermosiphon principles. In the next video, we also understand what is a thermosiphons, the water cooling system. So for watching these various cooling system, I request to visit the playlist. So you also access the playlist from the I symbol on the top right screen of your mobile. The circulation takes place due to the density difference between hot water leaving jacket and cold water entering the jacket. The natural circulation cooling is used only for small engine up to 22 kilowatt. Now next is the forced circulation cooling system. So I also already explained about the room. Forced circulation, in a room we use the fan because it is air. But in water cooling system, how do we transport the water? By using the pump. Okay, so when the water is come, we use the pump. When the air is there, then we need use the fan, blower or a compressor. So forced circulation, the pump is used to cause positive circulation of water in a water jacket. Forced circulation result in the better cooling of the engines and the better control of the water temperatures. So this is the diesel engine and the cold water supply by using the pump. Here you see the pump is put in. So what happen when we use the pump? Because when we use the pump, at that time the more mass of water is supplied to the engine. When the mass is more supplied, then what happen? The heat transfer is increased. So we know that the equation of heat transfer Q is equal to mCp delta T. So m is increased, at that time the heat transfer is increased. That's why it gives the better control of the water temperatures and we are able to reject the more of the heat from the diesel engines. Now next is the open cooling system. Now what is the meaning of open cooling system? Open means the continuously fresh water is supplied to the system. Its name is also suggest that. Okay, means cooling water supplied to the engine is continuously fresh. Okay, engine water is supplied to the engine, it remove the heat from the engines, and this water coming out from the engine is supplied to the waste or some heating process. Okay, So that we understand in this video, the water coming from the engine jacket is wasted or it is used for a process heating. So this is the diesel engine. We supplied the cold water and hot water is coming out. Okay. So this hot water is either supplied to a waste, means it is going in the drainage lines, or either it is for a process heating of the industry, or hot water is discharged directly either into a cooling pond. Cooling pond means it is one type of the lake, or a cooling tower where it is closed by atmospheric air. So here I show you, this is the diesel engine. The hot water coming out from the diesel engine is supplied to this cooling tower. Okay, in a cooling tower what happened, it's reduced the temperature of this hot water. So water is spray at the middle part of this cooling tower, and this side of from the bottom side is supplied the air. Then what happened here, the interaction of the air and water is takes place. So air is absorbed the heat from the water, and the cold water is collected at this lower part of the cooling tower. Then this cold water is again supplied to this diesel engine by using the pump. Okay, and the air is outlet from this upper part of the cooling tower. With this air, some amount of the water is also coming out. That's why we need to add some quantity of the water during this process. That's why it is known as the open cooling system. Next point is that this system is used where water supply is unlimited, means where the water source is continuously available. At that location we are able to use the this type of the system, because it's required lots of fresh water. The open system is very simple, and only a small electric power is required to run the pump. However, in this system, due to evaporation of water, the concentration of water impurities is increased. Okay, so during this evaporation of the water, water impurities is increased inside the engine, and its increase result in a corrosion and scale formation in the jacket. Means inside this engine there is a water jacket, so water jacket is start to corrosions and the scale formations, because we use the normal water and the another components of the cooling system. Next is the closed system. We already understand that is closed means the water supply is in the closed circuit, it is not the open circuit. Okay, so in a closed cooling system we have a two circuit. Okay, the one circuit is known as the primary circuit, and second circuit is known as the secondary circuits. Okay, so what is in the primary circuit, the distilled water is circulated through primary circuit. Okay, so what is the disadvantage in open system, that is a corrosion and scale formations. Okay, so that's why we use the distilled water in primary circuit, so we avoid the problem of corrosions and the scale formations. So in primary circuit we use distilled water, and normal water in a secondary circuit is used to absorb the heat from primary circuit with help of the heat exchangers as shown in this figure. So this is the diesel engine. The hot distilled water is coming. Okay, this hot distilled water is supplied in a one heat exchanger. So this is the heat exchanger. So in a heat exchanger, the distilled water is passed inside this tube of heat exchangers, and outside the normal water is available. Okay, then this distilled water is cooled in this heat exchangers, its temperature is reduced, and by using the pump it is again supplied to the diesel engine. So this circuit is known as the primary circuit. Okay, so in this heat exchangers we reduce the temperature of hot distilled water, so we are required to some another medium to cool the hot distilled waters. So this outside the tube we use the normal water. Okay, so here from this bottom part we supply the cold water, and this cold water is absorb the heat from distilled waters, so it remains the hot water. So this hot water is supplied to the cooling tower. In the cooling tower we spray the hot water. From the bottom part air is supplied, interaction of the heat and water is takes place, so temperature of the water is reduced, and the air is out from this upper part. And this cooling water is collected in the bottom part of the cooling tower, and this cold water is supplied to this heat exchanger by using the water circulating pump. So in this system we see that it is a two pump is used, so by default the more power is used compared to the another system. So if the water supply is unlimited, at that time we use the open system. But when the water supply is limited, at that time we need to use the closed system. Okay, means when in the open system we use the process heatings and another purpose, means here it is the come. Suppose we are also able to use this system as an open system, okay, that the hot this hot water is directly supplied to the waste, but here we recirculate it. Otherwise it is cooled in a cooling towers and circulate through the heat exchangers. The main advantage of this system is no scale formations, because the water jacket expose only distilled water, and this system permit the higher jacket temperatures, means it avoid the higher temperatures inside the water jacket, and the no scale formation is occur due to we use the distilled waters. However, this system require high investment cost and more electric power consumptions due to two water pump. Why its investment is higher? Because it's need to heat exchangers, it's required a two pump, it's required a cooling tower. So by default it cost is increase and it's use the more power because the two pump is used in this system. The closed cooling system is universally used in a diesel power plant, okay, because the water sources are limited. That's why the closed systems are majorly used in all the diesel power plants. Thank you for watching this video. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe the channels, comment on the video, and don't forget to share with your friend.